cracking my knuckles. Oh, by the way, did you guys ever see that, this is somewhat older news, but did anyone see the information about the dude who, like, spent his entire life only cracking the knuckles on one hand? And turns out that, no, you do not get arthritis for cracking your knuckles. That is an urban legend and a myth. It's an old wives' tale. Yeah, I think that's the term we want to go for, an old wives' tale. Which old wives go around telling each other. Did you know if you crack your knuckles that it gives you arthritis? Look, she's also wearing a sexy midriff revealing top. See? The manager did create the the dress code for the employees. Ow. Damn it. I should not have tried to punch him. Hey, you. Yeah, you. Get out of here. Does he even have a heart? Isn't he, like, pure energy? How does he have a heart? I guess everything has a heart in a way. Maybe it's just not a big red beating heart, though. Everything needs some sort of destructible point. Because otherwise it's too overpowered, and then your heroes can't beat it, and then, you know, you write yourself into a corner. Where it's like, damn, there's no way to kill this guy now. Shoot. I look strange. Yeah, I look strange. Uh-huh. Every time he says that, every time he says such insulting things to my characters, I get angry. Because my characters look fine. She's allowed to have the ears. The foxy ears. Doesn't make her look any stranger at all. Don't you worry, Shadow Dancer. He's just jelly. He's just jelly. Alright, continuing. I have no fatigue points. Well, there's only one thing for that, and that is fatigue potions. Let's continue. Let us continue on our path through this winding, snaking dungeon. Continue our path down Snake Way. Aw, man, I was so hype when Goku went down Snake Way in Dragon Ball Z when I first saw it. That was so cool. And he went through HFIL because they censored it, because apparently you aren't allowed to say hell on American TV, at least on Cartoon Network. Which is hella stupid. Does anyone say hella anymore? I don't think so. I don't think anyone even said hella in the first place. Or if they did, they were severely out of the loop of what was and was not socially acceptable to say, because you shouldn't say that. Shouldn't say that kind of word. It's a bad word. Ha! I was right. She was right, apparently. I don't know what she was right about, because I wasn't paying attention and we were just flying through dialogue so that we could play the game. But she was right. The general manager of Raw was right. Got him. Wrestling's been questionable lately. For anyone that doesn't watch, like wrestling, American wrestling, the WWE. It's been slightly better in some ways and slightly worse in other ways lately. They've stopped trying to shove John Cena down everyone's throat for the most part, but instead they're trying to shove the next generation of John Cena down everyone's throat. But then they had the brilliant idea of, hey, we've booked this John Cena-like guy and he gets booed all the time anytime we do that. And, it's not been going too well for us when it comes to that. And we've made him lose title shots constantly to try and build up, you know, other people being bad guys, and they cheer about that. So why not turn him into a bad guy and have him just go crazy on people and start beating the crap out of the guys who are wronging him? And it's working. People haven't really been, like, cheering him super hard or anything like that, but things have gone better in that particular booking, because that's the thing when you're writing these situations between heroes and villains, is that there have to be actual heroes and there have to be actual villains. And right now it's basically a war between a villain and a villain, but at the very least with that, you can see some progress in people's opinions of the guy. Because the way the WWE was written forever was basically like, let's use Dragon Ball Z as an example. Let's say Goku was just the most unlikable. Was just kind of unlikable. Nobody liked him. He didn't have any friends or anything like that. And he didn't like care about anyone else or anything like that. And he only cared about himself. And that would be your heroes in WWE. But they don't say anything rude or anything. So there's that, at least, would basically be their reasoning for why he's not a quote unquote bad guy. And it just seemed like they didn't get it, didn't understand what they needed to do to... And they still don't seem to get it, and get what good guys are, and what bad guys are, and understand that you should be booking people with charisma more than anything, because... I mean, that's what wrestling is. I'm not calling it wrestling, because it's a little bit staged. To a fair degree, but you know, you guys know. If you didn't know, I'm sorry. In addition to that, Santa Claus isn't real, the Easter Bunny isn't real, and the Tooth Fairy is real, but you don't want to meet that guy. That guy is not cool. He will take you into his windowless white van and take you for a ride that you don't want to go on. But I'm sorry if I destroyed all your childhood dreams now. And if I didn't, then, well, cool. But anyway, wrestling's not super real, so what you have to do is you have to have a storyline to make it entertaining to people. And I'm fine with that. I mean, the guys still do very, very physical stuff. The fights don't necessarily have to be real, and the stories can be entertaining. But then when the stories aren't entertaining, and they're predictable, and you don't know how to book people or how to write storylines for people or feuds or anything like that, then that's where you run into problems with that kind of thing. And I haven't really, like, watched wrestling. I, like, pop in now and again, and I see there's some people that I follow that do reviews for it and stuff like that, for pay-per-view stuff and whatnot. So I'm fine with that. But it's a situation where I want it to succeed, because when I was a little kid, I watched wrestling with, like, my big brother and my big sister when I was a real little kid. And I was really big into the WWF, and I liked The Rock, Stone Cold Steve Austin, Hulk Hogan, and Macho Man, and stuff like that. And I was a huge fan of it. And I grew up, and it kind of grew apart from me for a little while. But now that I'm even older, I'm like, oh, you know what? Let's go pop in, see what it's like, and it's... could use work. Could use improvement. If I was a teacher marking a test, I would say could use improvement right here when it comes to the current state of the WWE. They succeed in some things, and then in other things, it's like, oh, man. It's almost like they just don't know what they should be doing, and so they're trying to pander to the audience, but they're not doing it well. I think right now, if you were to put like an era name to wrestling, like kind of like how some things have like the Golden Age or the Silver Age or the Attitude Era, when it comes to wrestling, right now would be like the PG era, because everything going on is super kid friendly for the most part, and very, very conservative, which does not for great storytelling make. Once you get overly conservative with stuff, it detracts from what you can do with a lot of situations. That's not to say it can't be great with conservative writing and like kids writing and stuff like that. There are plenty of kids things that turn out really great. I mean, look at a bunch of Disney movies and stuff like that. I'm out of fatigue again. Damn it. I want more fatigue. More FP. Yeah, I got plenty of mileage. Shit. I didn't know I worked up so much again. Give me that. And give me this, since I can only use these one per day each. Just take one of each. Alright. We want 50 FP? 50 FP right now? We want the 20. Let's go with the 20 for now. Go with the 20 for now. We'll hit the 15 up soon afterwards. But yeah, when you make things too PG and you're too scared to do things, then you're not doing things. you know what I mean? You actually appeal to a much wider net of audience when you're able to go. I guess rated T for teen is probably the most the widest net you can cast for trying to appeal to people. Which means very minor adult situations may happen. Like cussing. Oh, cussing. Oh no, not that. However will we get by if our children hear a cuss word? Hey you. Hey you, come here. Hey kid, wanna see a magic trick? I'll make your life disappear while I scratch my head. My head is itchy underneath this headset that I'm wearing. Ow! Holy crap, that hurt. Okay, so I do actually have another thing I can talk about right now. Right meow. Right meow. And that is the like online guides you can find about how to do Let's Plays and YouTube stuff and whatnot. For any of you that might be interested in doing your own, and I'm sure that I'm the last person to be talking about it because my YouTube channel is too successful to talk about, and I shouldn't be giving out my amazing secrets, but here, I'm gonna tell you guys something right now. While sound quality does matter, if you can't, then you can't. Sometimes. Like, you may not necessarily be able to reach maximum sound quality or whatever, which all of the online guides or whatever you're gonna find for on YouTube or on this or that is gonna say, yo, you should spend big on a good mic and everything else can be done relatively easily, but make sure you got that super good mic. Sometimes you can't necessarily hit those goals. Oh, sweet. That count is my assassination order? All of my feet quests, huh? Feet quests available on current level. So, by that logic, I should wait until I'm max level to use. Or is that only everything that's available for the level that I'm at when I use it, or is it the level I'm at and below? Shoot. I don't know how these feat quest completion tickets work. Here, let's check. See all these featured quests? Look at them all. Look at all of them. They're not everything, and even if I check progress, I should probably have a few as well. Yeah, look at all these too. I'm not sure if that would complete all of them or not. I guess I'll find out very, very soon. Oh, that's only 1% XP? Shoot. 1% ain't much at all. Well, dang. Is it a crane token? Hey, I didn't know I had one of those. That's right, you get one through a quest line. I think I'll go spend this crane token and find out what I get from the crane. Let's go play the crane game! Let's go play the crane game! I don't want the modified laser gun, that's just a revolver. Nah. Is that all I'm gonna cycle through is this stuff here? Cause if that's the whole cycle, then I'll probably go for the legacy pot thief's weapon. Okay. We'll try. Oh. It was just showing stuff off. So plate armor, the superheat sword, the leather armor. Oh, I got nothing. I got nothing. Damn. I timed it just a little bit late. Well, darn. That's why you don't play the crane game. I'm actually not terribly bad at doing the crane game in real life. It's just, it's different in-game than it is from real life, that's for sure. Things are not generally on a conveyor belt in real life for the crane game. But yes, this secret to doing YouTube videos, yes, sound quality is important, but you can fudge it to a point if you become familiar with the software that you're using. For example, if I were to just take the very, very raw recording of my sound, of my audio, it would sound pretty bad. And it's very easy to blow out my mic, so I can't, like, scream into it or stuff unless I want to murder your ears, so I try not to. But at the same time, I think my sound quality's okay. Oh, jeez, that hurt. I think my sound quality is overall not bad. Not the worst in the world. And if it is, please correct me on my horrible misunderstanding of how my ears work. And this is certainly not the same as like as some things. Like, I don't have a super crisp clear quality, the perfection. But, you know. I think I've got something acceptable going on. I'd say the most important thing for any aspiring Let's Players is not necessarily the hardware you have, but understanding your software and how to use it. Why am I facing this guy again? I've already killed you multiple times. Squish. But yes, understanding your software, whether it be Adobe Premiere, or Audacity, or whatever you may be using, is very helpful for learning how to do your own personal Let's Play! Yay! Nerdy as fuck voice. I love it. Get out of here, Granite. Level 82. technically level 83 because we have that level up ticket. We're already level 83, technically. We're almost there. Almost there. And we've got a few million gold to account for it, too. So this character can pay back some of that massive loan that she took out from some of my other classes. Whenever you make a new character, that new character is going to take out a very large gold loan from your other classes if you care to do it relatively quickly. Having a character fund itself is nice and all, but it slows you down, that's for sure. That is 100% for sure. I do wish I could do a little bit more with my audio, though. If I had a nice microphone, I would be able to. No, I haven't changed my title in like, ever. I think I, like, still have Overflowing Mana or something. Yeah, I do. I do. I have that old-ass title. Super old title. But yeah, the issue with that is I don't, like, I'd rather be making content than trying to do something I can't and don't have the money for. Because I'd much rather be making content for you guys than off working some terrible, horrible job for a while in order to fund, like, having a better microphone and a sound card to go with it and the soundboard that inevitably will have to come, and possibly even like some sort of boom or something to hold the microphone so it's in a good spot. Like that's a few hundred dollars that I don't necessarily have. It's a few hundred dollars. Let's go talk with the princess. It's too bad you can't just have a video call with someone for fun. Like, you can only have video calls in this way for quests. Which is unfortunate. You know, maybe I want to, like, go call the princess and say, hey, what's up? How's it going? How's things? Yeah? Really? She gone. Damn. Lost the signal. Alright. Another fatigue potion. We're in there. We're in Grandine. We are in Grandine. We are so close to the end of our level up quest and journey. It's been a long road, as it always is. We're almost complete once more. And what do we have to show for it? Nothing. Just a bunch of ungrateful people that don't even watch. I find it rather interesting how like subscriptions on YouTube and Twitch work. Like, generally, people only get like 10%. Their views are only about 10% as high as their subscription number, which is weird. Generally, not always. I mean, there's outliers. Like, for example, PewDiePie has an insanely high subscription count and much, much lower viewer count because there's a lot of people that subscribe to him just to be subscribed to him. Which is also weird. I don't know why. If you you don't like the content, you shouldn't even subscribe to the person. I don't know. That goes all into like the psychology of people. People confuse me all the time. People make no sense. They don't follow logic. They don't follow common sense all the time. Common sense isn't even common anymore. Common sense is basically a superpower now. There's so few people in the world that ever get it. It's like a It's like if X-Men were real, their mutation would be common sense. That's how things are going in the real world right now. What we should do is that we should prove our common sense by building a wall. And this wall is going to be huge. It'll be huge. You ever notice Donald Trump doesn't say huge? He says huge. With like Y-O-O-G-E. Huge. It's going to be huge. I saw something very funny. It was comparing like presidential candidates to Game of Thrones character. They compared Donald Trump to King Joffrey, and it's like an overly entitled rich prick who just wants everything his way and is willing to do just about anything to get it. Kinda. Yeah, you're not wrong. You're not wrong. And then Ted Cruz was a White Walker. Arguably the scariest one in the whole situation. Quite possibly the destruction of humanity. I found it very funny. Oh man. Oh yeah, let's destroy this thing. So that we can destroy that thing. Perfect. No problem. No problemo. Easy peasy. White Walker. Quite possibly the most dangerous one of them all. Hard to tell, though. Okay, you know what? Maybe I should have a different... I could take Pirate King, wouldn't be too bad of a title. Or, Level 70 would actually be a pretty good title as well. We'll keep Pirate King, why not? I'm level 85, we'll outrank both of them late soon enough. Let's continue! Yay! Hooray! How long has this recording been going on now? Approaching 2.5 hours. Good. This is going to take forever to edit. By which I mean the entire process. It's going to take forever to edit. As it always does. You know, if anything takes forever to edit, it's my Pokemon Let's Play. I'm basically creating the Pokédex from scratch in it. Well, not from scratch, but from, I'm basically creating the Pokédex. Which is fun, though. I enjoy creating the Pokédex. See, that's the thing about Let's Playing and stuff like that, is that as long as it's fun, I don't care how much work it is. I enjoy it, so I'll do it. That, and of course, I'd very much appreciate it if, like, it gets views, because that helps a lot. It helps a whole lot when it gets more than like a couple views, you know. It's very disheartening to put your all into something and then very, very little feedback is given. But yeah, again, that's the nature of it. Not everything is going to be successful right away. And hopefully I'll find a way to grow. Hopefully. At the very least, I think I'm like the dungeon fighter guy when it comes to doing like character playthroughs. There's Aegis Rick who does like specific guides and stuff on events when they come out, which is cool too. But if you want to see like raw gameplay of a character class from like level 1 and up, I'm your guy. I'm your man. Unfortunately, you have to deal with me talking, so that's a bit of a turnoff too. Maybe I should just do an entire silent Let's Play, just like, hey guys, thanks for watching. I'm gonna play this class now, and then say nothing for the rest of it, and at the end, thanks for watching, guys, I hope you liked it. I hope you enjoyed. I'll see you next time. Bye. Like, comment, and subscribe. I try not to do the whole like, comment, and subscribe thing, because I'd like to think that if you liked it, you'll like it. If you have a comment, you'll comment. And if you want to see more, you'll subscribe on your own. I do put like a subscribe button at the end of plenty of videos, but even that, I'm starting to rethink whether I should do it or not, because I go back and think, like, of all the YouTube videos I've watched, how many times have I clicked on that subscribe button, or that playlist button, or that next video button, or whatever, at the end of that, and the number is, like, very low, like, almost never. Generally, I just, go to their channel on my own, or whatever, but I'm finding out that I'm not the standard YouTube viewer, and I don't follow the standard YouTube, routine? Maybe? Something like that? And, I'm not necessarily the same as most people that go on YouTube and stuff like that, or go on Twitch. So, there's also that. Maybe it's just me, but I don't think a lot of people actually click on those things at the end of videos. Once in a while, I'll see something that interests me, but usually not all that much. It's like the same time where I usually don't click on the thing with, hey, I'm streaming live now on Twitch. Because I'm pretty sure I'd follow you on Twitch, but then again, Twitch is really, really bad with properly showing when people are online, so putting up a YouTube video is probably more helpful than usual. Man, Twitch is sometimes garbage. Like, YouTube streaming service isn't very good, and is not going to succeed more than likely. Mainly because Twitch exists already, and plenty of other streaming services already exist and are established, and jumping into it later than everyone else like this means you have to have some big, amazing thing to incentivize people to use that instead of another service. It's like all those MMOs that jumped in, like after World of Warcraft came out, to be like, hey, we've got an MMO too, it's just like World of Warcraft. Well, if it's just like World of Warcraft, why wouldn't I just keep playing World of Warcraft? It's the same thing with this. Like, if YouTube streaming service is the same quality or worse than Twitch's, then why would I stream there and not Twitch, where there's a much larger possible audience there as well? So it's weird. It makes okay, Cone, you say you do your fighting with your fists, and technically you're telling the truth, but a big robotic fist isn't the same as that as what your words implied, sir. The implication is different. But anyway, after that sidetrack. Anyway, seeing as YouTube streaming service is no better than Twitch's, I don't see how it can succeed. And even if there wasn't Twitch's, there's also Azubu or Afrika, which are foreign streaming services. So even if YouTube like wants to appeal to a wide worldwide audience and stuff like that, it's just like you guys are too slow on the uptake, unfortunately. You took too long to get into the game, and now the game is over, the game is past. Oh, one more thing regarding Twitch. If you play advertisements on your Twitch stream, I shake my head at you, man. It's supposed to be about the game, not the money, man. You're selling out. And it's fine to sell out. Just sell out in a way that's not detrimental to the quality of your stream. Just playing ad, seeing a bunch of ads sucks dick for anyone. I say as ads are probably popping up and playing on my YouTube video for people. Aw man, I'm sorry. Am I out of FP again? Damn it! Damn it all to hell, I'm out of FP again! Oh cool, I got another pot at least. I don't know that I'm going to be... I don't believe I will be able to finish up the the level up process right now. I'm out of FP again, and the only way to get FP right now are with the Trinity coins. But I want to spend them on better things. So yeah, I think that's going to be the end of the stream, guys. I can't do much without FP. What I can do, I'll open up... I got 6 skeleton keys, so let's open some lost treasures. We've got a Piraeus egg. Ooh. And some demon invitations. Well, would you look at that? We got a free Piraeus egg for Nocturnus. How nice. How very nice. That's actually not bad. That's a pretty good item to pop out of the... It's a pretty darn good item to pop out of a lost treasure. Yo, that's a good note to leave off on. Alright. Cool. Thank you all very, very much for watching. I will be, I'll be back tomorrow with the final phase of our farming. The final phase. The last couple of levels. Especially considering the fact that we have some level up tickets available for ourselves. So we will be reaching the max level on our next recording. I'm sorry I couldn't do it today, but we're out of FP. It happens. So I'll see you guys on the next one. Thanks very much for watching. Bye-bye, everybody. I'm sorry that my outros are always so darn long. You probably already closed the video. Yep, you've closed the video. You're not watching this at all. I can say anything I want. Anything I want. Donald Trump is the best president that will ever exist. Hooray! Political views that aren't actually real. Bye, everybody. Bye-bye.